Hello there. In this video, I'm going to show you guys how you can export a DaVinci Resolve project with all of its media files in one single folder so you can further upload it to the cloud, create backups, transfer it to another system and edit it there and do all these kinds of stuff. So let's see how it's done. Now as you can see here, I've got this reel that I had edited previously for my Instagram. Now let's say I want the project file and all of the media of this reel to be collected by DaVinci Resolve itself. I don't want to pick every single file from every folder, right? So what I'm going to do is go to this little icon down here that says Project Manager, or go to File and then Project Manager, Shift 1. Yeah, then this little window will open up. Here I've got this project of this reel. All I have to do is right click on it and go to Export Project Archive. Once you click on that, it will ask you where you want to save that project archive, and it will be of the extension of .dra, right? Then you can name it and save it anywhere you want. I'm going to go with downloads itself. So I'll hit save and then I'll go back to DaVinci. Yeah, this little window right here. Then it will ask me if I want to export the media files. Yes, of course, we want all of the media files. Do I also want the render cache? Now, render cache is kind of optional, because if you have a very huge project, then the render cache seems to pile up, right? So the file that eventually will get exported will be huge. So you don't really want that. You can also create it on another system. So render cache is optional. I'm going to uncheck that. And of course, proxy media. Now, if you don't know the concept of proxy media, how to generate that, there's a video on it on the top right of your screen. You can watch that and then come back. Now, proxy media, of course, again, if you have huge footages and you have generated the proxy media for it already, of course, go ahead with it, because it will be useful on another system, right? So just check that, and these three options are all you get. And of course, again, it'll ask you where to save it, which we have already selected. Then all you have to do is hit OK, let it take its time. It's done. Yeah. Now, if I go to my File Explorer and if I go to Downloads, as you can see here, Reel and Shorts .dra, and it has got the project file, of course, .drp, DaVinci Resolve project, and media files. So in Downloads, I've got this little screenshot. Then in Essentials, I've got all of this. Then in YouTube stuff, I've got all of this. So there's all kinds of stuff right here, right? So media files have been collected. Next, how to import it to another system, right? Because we've already got this. Now I'm going to transfer it to my external drive, take it with me and attach it to my laptop or something and start editing it from there. How to do it? Go to DaVinci Resolve on that system, right click anywhere in the project manager and click on Restore Project Archive. Once you click on that, there's no need to open this folder. Just click on the folder, hit open, and then name whatever the you want to the project. I'm going to name it Reel. Yeah, hit OK. And then it has created another project called Reel. If I open it, as you can see, everything is back to as it was, right? I've got all the folders that I had created inside the bins. Then I've got dialogue, footage, images, everything. There's no need to relink anything. Everything is right here, and then I can continue editing from there. So that's how you can export a project in DaVinci Resolve with all of its media files and then create backups or share it to another system and continue from there. Now, a few things to note. First question that gets asked much frequently is that, does this work cross-platform, like from Windows to iOS or iOS to Windows? Yes, it will. All you have to do is follow this process and it will work. Second thing to note, it's pretty obvious, but I'll still tell you guys, if you're transferring this project on your external hard drive and plugging it to another system and starting editing, make sure that you then transfer it from the hard drive to that system and then unplug it. Otherwise, it will show media offline. So make sure that the media files get copied on that another system and then you continue editing. It's pretty obvious, but still. So these were the few things I wanted to tell you guys. Now, I know that this feature is going to come in really handy for you guys, and that's why I hope you guys find this video useful. And if you do, make sure you like this video. It really helps the algorithm suggest this video to the needful people. Also, share this video with your friends and consider subscribing to the channel. I post such kind of editing tutorials, how to tech videos, tech reviews, I stream games occasionally, and I post some knowledgeable and informative YouTube shorts. I also have a website where I post weekly blogs about all of the stuff that I just mentioned, and a Gumroad shop where I share essential motion graphic elements for super affordable prices. So that brings us to the end of the video, guys. Thank you for watching the video. I'll see you all next time. Bye bye.